السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على السلام حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا
بسم الله إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد إن أصدق حديث كتاب الله عز وجل وأحسن حديث حديث محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر أمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة دلالة وكل دلالة في النار Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. All praise is due to Allah Azza wa Jal. We praise Him and we extol Him. And we seek refuge in Allah from the evil within ourselves and the evil results of our wrong actions. Whomsoever Allah guides, none can be led astray. And whomsoever Allah allows to be left in misguidance, there is no guide for that person. Verily, the most truthful of speech is the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. And the finest guidance is the guidance of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And the most evil of affairs are the newly invented ones. For verily, every newly invented matter is a bid'ah, a going astray. And every bid'ah leads to the hellfire. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we all realize that the month of Ramadan is coming to an end. And Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, as this blessed month is, it comes with a lot of blessings and barakat, khafir. A lot of blessings and a lot of blessings that we cannot even enumerate. If we were to try and enumerate the many countless blessings of Allah, then we would not be able to do so. So Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, Subhanallah, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, that this month is coming to an end, and the believers are sad in one sense that the month is coming to an end, and the energy levels of the people who are doing the good deeds will be decreasing very much so, because the shayateen are going to start to come out and inhibit mankind from doing good deeds. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. And there's no strength and there's no might and power except by the permission of Allah. This blessed guest of Ramadan is now preparing to leave. But Alhamdulillah, as such, this blessed month is not going to leave us without leaving us with some parting gifts. Bidnillah ta'ala, all of us had received some sort of blessings and understandings throughout this month of Ramadan. But the end of this blessed month of Ramadan is something special. It's something very mysterious, and it's packed with utmost amount of blessings that can only be found if the person seeks after it. Because we know the noble hadith of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said, in a general sense, man sama Ramadan iman wa ihtisaban ghafara lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi. That the Prophet ﷺ said that whoever fasts in the blessed month of Ramadan with iman, with faith, and hoping and anticipating the reward from Allah Azza wa Jal for their fast, then Allah Azza wa Jal will wipe out their previous sins. Allah will forgive their previous sins. But it's also been confirmed in a hadith on the authority of Abu Hurairah that the Prophet ﷺ said, من قام ليلة القدر إمام واحتساب غفر الله ما تقدم من ذنبه. أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. That the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم also said in a similar hadith on the authority of Abu Hurairah رضي الله عنه that whosoever stands on the ليلة القدر, the night of decrees, with iman and hoping, with faith, full faith, and hoping in the reward of Allah Azza wa Jal, then Allah Azza wa Jal will forgive them their previous sins. So when we have two hadith similar, these hadith are saying the exact same thing. But what is the difference? If one were to look at these hadith and look at the general context in it, that the Prophet ﷺ is alluding to, that in general, that any Muslim who fasts from the beginning of Ramadan to the end, with believing in Allah and hoping for his reward, they'll be forgiven. And whoever stands on the night of power, then Allah will forgive them their sins. So these hadiths are similarly very the same. So what is the sense in seeking after that night of Qadr? What is the sense of making that extra effort? Why would the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam make the extra effort in the last 10 nights of Ramadan? He Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam would not sleep, and he would eat a lot less, and he would tighten his waist strap, and he would make more effort in the last 10 nights of Ramadan. Even though he Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam made the statement that whoever fasts in Ramadan, Allah will forgive them their sin with faith and hoping in the reward. And whosoever stands Laylatul Qadr, they will receive the similar benefit. But these two ahadith are similar, but there is a very distinct difference in these two hadith. Because Allah Azza wa Jal had put on the tongue of the noble Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam an explanation of the reward, the elevated state of the reward of the person who stands on the night of Qadr, who is seeking after that Laylatul Qadr. It's not as the person who just fasts Ramadan. This is something that is general. Because why Allah Azza wa Jal, the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that we should give a zakat al-fitr at the end of Ramadan, there's a specific purpose for that reason. that it will help to wipe out, efface the sins that we may have committed during our fast in the month of Ramadan. So the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was alluding to the fact that whoever can stand and can reach Laylatul Qadr and be doing this with the hope that Allah Azza wa Jalla will not just obliterate their sins, but will achieve a higher status, a higher state and reward. Because there's an authentic hadith which can be found on the authority of Imam Ahmed and Tirmidhi and Nisa'i and Ibn Majah, that is recorded and has been graded as Hasan on the authority of Aisha or the Anha, that she said, asking the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Ya Rasulullah, if I were to meet Laylatul Qadr, if I were to be one of those yani people who Allah Azza wa Jal had blessed with meeting Laylatul Qadr, then what should I say? What should I recite? The Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said from his Juwam al-Kalim, from his well-known concise type of speech, the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam gave her a very concise response to her concise questioning. He Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam guided her to a set of phrases that is very concise and specific by saying Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to her and to all of us that we should recite, قُلْ أَلْهُمَّ إِنَّكَ عَفُونَ قُدْحِبُ الْعَفْقُ عَفُ عَنِّي أَلَّهُمَّ Oh my Lord, oh my Creator, oh my Lord, أَلْهُمَّ إِنَّكَ You are the one who is عَفُونَ تُحِبُ الْعَفُقُ عَفُ عَنِّي You love to pardon. You are the loving and the pardoning one. So, oh my dear Lord, pardon me because you love to pardon. So please pardon me. So this, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, is something which is very specific. It is a set of phrases. And if Allah Azza wa Jalla has blessed us to be of those who are standing, and it doesn't mean that we should just be standing, because some women are on their menses. So it doesn't mean that they cannot recite these words of remembrance. They can learn these words. Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afu fa'fu anni. The woman can also recite these words. So if we're able to stand, then we should be standing and praying and anticipating that Allah Azza wa Jal would wipe out our sins. And if the women are not able to stand because they're in their monthly cycle, they could be standing or they could be sitting, reciting words of adhkar, remembrance. But more specifically, they should learn this dua. It's an authentic dua that anybody can learn. Anybody can memorize it and anybody can recite it. Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afu fa'fu anni. So, oh Allah, oh my dear Lord, you are the all-forgiving and you love to forgive. So, forgive me. This attribute, my dear brothers and sisters, of afu, from Allah Azza wa Jalla, the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's tongue, Nawwa Kamal Kareem, his blessed tongue, is explaining that aside from the fact that if we fast the month of Ramadan, Allah can put a veil between us and our sins. But if we were of those whom Allah Azza wa Jalla had blessed with the tawfiq to be of those who are awake and vigilant, making adhkar and praying and supplicating to Allah on the last 10 nights of, and hopefully bi'idhnillah ta'ala, we'll catch one of the nights of al-Qadr. Allah Azza wa Jal, being al-Afu, can efface our sins. This attribute of Allah Azza wa Jal, this noble attribute of Allah Azza wa Jal as the eraser, that we can come to Allah Azza wa Jal with sins, and Allah Azza wa Jal would just erase it as if it did not exist. I want to give a little metaphor, an example of this attribute of Al-Afu, that Allah Azza wa Jal erases and effaces sins. As a person or a group of people who had traversed and walked in the desert. They walked and they traveled in the desert, and after they passed through the desert, the wind blew. And it moved and it removed all of the traces of any footsteps on the desert. So then Allah Azza wa Jal is al-afu. In a similar sense, وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلُ الْعَالَى. For Allah Azza wa Jal is the highest example. Allah being al-afu, He will erase that, the spots of our steps or the board that we've made mistakes in, as if it didn't even exist. As if it did not even exist. This is Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah will erase it. It's al-afu, as if He didn't even notice it. So Allah Azza wa Jal, He says that in this blessed moment, this night of power, this Laylatul Qadr, Allah Azza wa Jal, He says in the Quran, and there's many ayat explaining the blessedness and the high exaltedness of this Laylatul Qadr. Allah Azza wa Jal says in Surah Qadr, تَنَزَلَ الْمَلَائِكَةَ وَرُوحُ فِيهَا بِإِذْنِ رَبِّهِمْ بِقُولِ أَمْرٍ سَلَامٌ هِيَ حَتَّى مَطْلَعِ الْفَجْرِ. That therein, in this blessed night, the Allah Azza wa Jal sends down the angels and the ruh with every matter, with every decision, and it will be salam. It will be a source of peace and tranquility hatta matl al-fajr, until the fajr comes in. So Allah Azza wa Jal says that what is coming down to us in this noble time period, this time of al-qadr, is something that is very mysterious indeed. And the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, whenever my Sahaba are being spoken about, are mentioned, and the Qadr, famsiku. That he said, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, that we should hold back. We should hold back from speaking about our the Sahaba. And we should hold back in trying to explain away the Qadr. Because this is something that is a mystery of Allah Azza wa Jal. And this, my dear brothers and sisters, is something that we should try and seek after. Because when Allah Azza wa Jal says that, in this night, Allah Azza wa Jal is sending down the angels, the multitude of angels that we cannot even enumerate. And on top of that, Allah Azza wa Jal is sending down the ruh. And the Mufassirin, they have explained that this ruh is Jibreel alayhi salam. That the noble angel, the archangel Jibreel alayhi salam, is also coming down with those other multitudes of angels on that blessed night of al-Qadr. Salam, Allah says, Salamun hiya hatta matla' al-fajr. That in this night there will be peace and tranquility. Because of the multitude of angels and the shayateen, they will have no way. The shayateen al jinn wal ins, they will have no way to try and make any harm. They will not have any way to make any harm, because the amr will be descended and it will be distributed amongst his ibad. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله وأتوب إليه. بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. هدى وبعد. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, this moment that we're heading in, it could have passed us and we could be heading towards it, because there's authentic hadith that the Prophet ﷺ said that this Layl of Qadr, this night of destination, this night can be on the 27th night, it could be on the 23rd night, it could have passed us and it could be ahead of us. So what is upon us is that we should seek after it. We should be constantly vigilantly seeking after it. Even if the ladies are not praying, they should be up making tasbih, making dua. And they should also try their best to memorize this dua and recite it. Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afu fa'fu anni. Oh my Lord, you are the most of forgiving and you love to pardon and erase sins, so pardon me. Allah Azza wa Jal, He says in the Quran and many in other places in reference to this night of Qadr, that Allah Azza wa Jal says, "Fiha yufru kul amrin hakim." In this night, Allah Azza wa Jal, He had made determination of all of our affairs. All of our affairs will be meted out. Allah Azza wa Jal will be distributing all of our needs and our wants in this night of Qadr for our year. Our yearly needs and wants will be distributed in this night. So Allah Azza wa Jal is urging us to get up and make an effort and ask Him to erase our sins, to start a new slate, to turn over a new slate in this blessed night of Qadr, so Allah Azza wa Jal can give us what we ask for and what we need to carry out our needs and our wants in this blessed night of Qadr. Those of us, as Ibn Abbas said, who are intended to make al-Hajj this year, the coming year, then they will be of those who are written to make the Hajj. Those of us who are written for them to marry, or is intended for them to get married, or to go on a journey to seek more rizq and livelihood, and then it will be determined on that night of termination. Allah Azza wa Jal, He said, yani in another ayat in the Quran, in Surah Al-A'la, Allah, at the very beginning of Surah Al-A'la, Allah Azza wa Jal says, سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى. Allah Azza wa Jalla, He says at the very onset of the Surah Al-A'la, the Most High, that glory, praise and glory be to Allah, the Most High, who has created everything and fashioned it, and has proportioned everything in its due proportion, and has given everybody what they need, and in a very due measurement. Allah Azza wa Jalla has proportioned everything, and He has measured everything, and has given everybody the due amount that they deserve. This is what Allah Azza wa Jalla says at the very beginning of Surah Al-A'la. Glory be Allah, to Allah, belongs to Allah. سَبِّحْ اسْمَ رَبِّكَ الْعَالَى الَّذِي خَلَقَ فَسَوَّى. Allah Azza wa Jalla, He created us and He fashioned us. Some tall, some short, some fat, some skinny, some black, some white, some green, some yellow. Allah created us and He fashioned us. And then what we're supposed to have. Whatever we're supposed to have is been distributed. So we have to give praise to Allah for that fact. So the Imams of the Sunnah are in consensus that Allah Azza wa Jal, He created خلق القلب, and then He gave us predestined limits. He had created us and He gave all of us a limit. We can only do so much. We maybe want to do so much other things, or maybe be eager to do so many things, but we can only do what Allah Azza wa Jal has determined us to do. Allah Azza wa Jal, he knew everything that would occur before it occurred. Before anything occurred, Allah Azza wa Jal, He knew what would occur. Allah Azza wa Jal, He خلق القاب. In Allah, the Prophet ﷺ said, In Allah, كتب المقادير. Allah Azza wa Jal, كتب المقادير. Allah Azza wa Jal, He created and He written down all of the maqadir, all of the predestined actions of the sons and daughters of Adam. يعني قبل خلق السماوات والأرض يعني بخمسين ألف. Before 50,000 years, Allah Azza wa Jal, He had created the creation and He had predestined to do whatever we're supposed to do and to be whatever we're supposed to be 50,000 years before He created anything. So whatever we're going to get, it has already been predestined for us. But what are we supposed to do? This is something that is very strange amongst a sect of this Ummah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, called Al-Qadariya, that they believe that we have no control over our affairs. We are like a leaf blowing in the wind. We cannot do anything. Allah is in control of everything. Allah Azza wa Jal, He has given us faculties of reason. He's given us hands and He's given us speech and He's given us legs to move. So it's a consensus of the Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, the Imam of the Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. All of our actions are predestined by Allah Azza wa Jal. But we are in complete opposition to the Qadariya, who believe that we have no control over our actions and Allah is in complete control over our actions. We have the choice in our matters. Allah has given us free will and choice. Arada. We have a will. We can choose whatever we want to do. We can choose whatever we want to eat. We can choose whomsoever we want to marry. But ultimately, it's Allah who's guiding us to our choices in life. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, don't let anybody try and fool us into believing that we have no control over our actions. We have control over our actions. And it's not for anyone to say that whatever we do, we cannot do it. We don't have the power to do it. It's only Allah. Allah Azza wa Jal has given us the free will to choose to stand or to sit. We know that. But we have a choice. So it's always upon us to choose the better. No one will choose anything that is inferior. As Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we always want to choose that which is better for us. If we had the means, we would choose that which is better. We would never choose something which was inferior and blame it on the Qadr of Allah Azza wa Jal. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, I would like to just leave us off with a statement of one of the Salaf. And this is a hadith that has been recorded by Ibn Mas'ud radhiyallahu anhu, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, by he other than him, la ilaha illa ghayru, by him, Allah Azza wa Jal, whom there is no other God except him, one of you might be performing the deeds of the people of paradise until he is just one arm's length, one dira, an arm's length away from him and the paradise and the qadr, whatever is written, the taqdeer is overtakes him and he starts to do the deeds of the people of the hellfire and then he enters into the hellfire. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. And he said, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, on the other hand, one of you can be doing the deeds all his life of the people of the Nar, of the Hellfire, be living a life of sin and transgression, but they can be just a hand span away from them and the Nar, but what Allah Azza wa Jalla has written for them overtakes them, the taqdeer. Overtakes them, and they start to do the deeds of the people of Al-Jannah, and then they enter into the Jannah. So the Prophet ﷺ, when he said this to this noble Sahabi, how is that? That Allah Azza wa Jal had written for us everything, so then why do we have to do any work? He ﷺ, he said, عَمِلُوا, do the work. فَكُلُكُمْ مَيَسْرِ بِمَا قُلِقَ اللَّهِ, do the work. May Allah have mercy and bless Ashab Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam for them asking that noble question. So that removes any doubt that the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when they asked the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, if Allah Azza wa Jal already preordained everything for us, then why should we work? He Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said, do the work. Do the work, because we will all be made easy. Allah Azza wa Jalla will facilitate it for us to do the deeds that we were created for. If we were created for the Jannah, then Allah Azza wa Jalla will facilitate for us to be of those who are regular to go to the masjid and do the deeds of Ahl al-Jannah and giving us sadaqat and giving the salams. As the Prophet ﷺ, he said, لا يدخل الجنة حتى تؤمنوا ولا تؤمنوا حتى تهابوا. He ﷺ said that you will not enter into paradise until you believe, and you will not become believers until you begin to love one another. Black, white, green, yellow, until you love one another. He said, can I not guide you to something that if you did it, you will start to develop love amongst yourselves. Spread the greetings of peace. These little things that we do, my dear brothers and sisters, can help us to entitle us to be of those who enter into the Jannah. The Ashab Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, they're in a regular habit of greeting each other. Whenever they met each other, they would say, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is ilaj. This is a medicine for the ills that are in our hearts. When we meet our brother, we meet him with a cheery and happy face, regardless of whether he's from your country or from your jama'ah. You meet your Muslim brother and you greet him by saying, Salam. And he replies to you, and you shake hands. The Rasul ﷺ said that the sins will drop off of you, will leave you by that simple act of greeting one another and shaking hands until you remove your hand from your brother's hand. And what is the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ? He ﷺ was in the habit of whenever he greeted his Muslim brother, he would face them. He would face them face to face and greet him and say, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, and shake their hand. And he ﷺ wouldn't be in a hurry to release his hand from his brother's hand. This is the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. If we get in the habit of doing these seemingly small sunnahs, then they can help us to be one of those whom Allah Azza wa Jalla entitled to be of Ahl al-Jannah. So when we meet our brother, it's not the sunnah to meet your brother with a hug or a kiss. It is a sunnah to meet your brother and to say Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah wa barakat, and he is to reply and say Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullah wa barakat. Mithlu, the same. And shake your brother's hand. You greet your brother and you shake their hand. This is a very blessed sunnah that we should try and revive by Ramadan, in Ramadan and after Ramadan. And this is a simple way that we can get the maghfirah of Allah, the forgiveness of Allah, and it can entitle us to be one of those Ahl al-Jannah. So may Allah help us, inshallah, and give us the tawfiq. And Allah Azza wa Jalla, may Allah record us of those whom we can stand up, yani qam laylatul qadr. That Allah Azza wa Jalla can record us of those who can stand in qiyam and praying laylatul qadr, iman wa ihtisaban, with faith and hoping in the reward of Allah Azza wa Jalla. And for our sisters, may Allah make it easy for you all, if you are even on your menses, to wake up and to be up vigilant and asking Allah, Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afu fa'fu anni. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallam tasliman. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka Hamidum Majid. Allahumma barik ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استو مستقيم make your line straight don't leave any gaps for the shaitan enough room at the back is there enough room at the back inshallah there isn't there's more room in the front Sisters, make your line straight. Stand close to your sisters. Don't leave any gap for the shaitan. Jazakallah khair.